training that needs to be addressed, okay? As you can see, that this version is consists of six different blocks, okay? Starting off with the lifestyle block, your basic movement skills, your general conditioning, your strength, your power, and your sports performance. And what this pyramid does, that it acts as a blueprint for how to plan out your strength and conditioning so that your strength training is safe, it's effective, it takes into account any imbalances or injuries that might be magnified in your sport, it reduces your risk of injury. And when you plan it out like this, lads, every block that you work on is always going to be strengthened or weakened by the quality of the block underneath it, okay? So my basic movements is going to be affected by my lifestyle. My strength will be affected by my lifestyle and my basic movements. My general conditioning will be affected by my basic movements and my lifestyle. My power will be affected by the strength, the general conditioning, the basic movements and the lifestyle components, okay? And what you want to do is you want to make sure that each block is as optimal as possible before working on the next block within your training. So what I'll do is I'll go through the different blocks here and I'll just give you some examples of what's included in each block. So the lifestyle block down here includes things like your sleep patterns, your nutrition, your postural habits, such as are you sitting all day, are you slouching a lot, do you recover, do you drink too much alcohol, are you partying too much. So all those would be part of your lifestyle, okay? Then the next one up here is your basic movement skills, okay? So how good does your body move under no pressure really, okay? So you're not loading up with weight or anything, just how good can you do some basic movements, okay? For instance, your joint mobility, do you have good joint mobility? Can you move your shoulders? Can you hinge your hips the way they're meant to be hinged? Can you touch your toes, which most people can't? Can you pass what we call the FMS, which is the functional movement screen, which is a system we use in the gym for assessing and grading your movement patterns and to show pain or any huge imbalances from side to side, okay? So they would all be components of the basic movement skills block. The next block up then is your general condition, okay? So like, can you do a few push-ups, can you do a few chin-ups? You're doing some medicine ball work, you're like doing general learning how to deadlift, learning how to squat. So you're getting movement, okay? And what this does, lads, it gets your endurance, your stamina up, but it also prepares your ligaments, it prepares your muscles, your tendons, all at the same pace, okay? And you're building up to a basic level, okay? You're not going into a very advanced level of strength training or anything on this, you're just getting generally conditioned, okay? And what happens a lot is people skip this and they go straight to your strength training. And what happens is their ligaments, their tendons all develop slower than your muscles. So people's muscles start growing, they start pulling on your tendons, which are having a hard time catching up. And again, it leads to injuries and strain and pain. Okay? So this kind of stops that from happening. The next block up there is your strength, okay? And in the strength block, you're really focusing on getting strong, okay? Which means that you're generally loading your body up, you're lifting heavier weights, you're doing lower reps, you're setting a good strength foundation upon which to build your power, okay? And it generally includes full body movements such as squats, deadlifts, chin-ups, weighted chin-ups, presses like shoulder presses, bench presses. And it also includes that it's getting strong each limb, so one-legged stuff or one-arm exercise, all that kind of stuff. The next block up here then, guys, is your power, okay? Which, and a lot of power exercises include jumps, versions of the Olympic lifts, like power cleans and snatches. You've got sprint work, you've got speed lifts, which would be like deadlifts with a lighter weight and going fast. You've got medicine ball work, so all that comes into the power. And then here, lads, you've got your sport-specific kind of exercises, really, which obviously depends on what sport you're in. And a lot of the sport-specific stuff training, like whether GA, rugby, or running, or triathlons, a lot of the sport-specific training would actually be going into to counterbalance the negative effects of that sport. So, for example, if you're a cyclist and you're cycling for 3 hours, four or five times a week, and you're in this rounded position, that's going to negatively affect your posture. You're going to have your upper back issues. Okay, so a lot of the sport specific training will be going back in to kind of counterbalance that, to get your posture back. Okay, So the way it works, lads, is that if something here isn't right, it will negatively affect what's above it, okay? So for instance, if you take any block in the pyramid, for instance, if we take your general conditioning here, okay? So if I'm trying to get my general conditioning up, my general fitness, my general endurance up, okay, and I'm doing my whatever runs or doing my mental ball work, I'm doing my circuit training, doing my push-ups, lunges, all that kind of stuff. If I'm doing that, yet I have a very bad limitation, say, in my hip, okay? So my joint mobility is subpar. What's going to happen is that although I will be sweating and getting generally fitter, I am putting a lot of stress on this joint, okay, on my hip joint, which is restricted. So I'm going to be deconditioning this bad pattern, which eventually is going to cause the muscle and the hip to lock up, which is going to lead to injury down the line, okay? Also, if we stay with the general conditioning, if I'm trying to get conditioned and I'm doing all what I said, like all my circuits and my runs and my cycles, yet my sleep patterns are out, my sleep is going to lead to being stressed. It's going to cause hormone imbalances in my body. It's going to cause me to get tighter, lack of energy. So again, my general conditioning isn't going to be as good as it could be. Okay. Another, if we go to the basic movements here. So if I'm limited, say in my toe touch. So I'm trying to touch my toes and I'm having a lot of trouble doing it. Okay. Not being able to touch your toes means that there's a huge imbalance somewhere. There should be no problem to touch your toes. But most people can't do it. So I might say, okay, I can't touch my toes, therefore I have to do my stretching, okay? So I'm doing my stretching, I'm working on all my mobility, but if my nutrition is out, and for instance I'm not drinking enough water, I'm going to be dehydrated, and dehydration is going to cause me to tighten up even more. So I can be doing all my mobility stuff, all my stretches, but if I'm dehydrated, then this isn't going to be as good as it could be. A better way to look at it would be saying, okay, I'm dehydrated, I need to get hydrated, and if I get hydrated, that will have a positive impact on my toe touch, okay? Another way we could look at it here, guys, is that if I take my power, so in a lot of sports, you need power, so you need to be explosively jumping, you're taking off fast, but if I don't have the strength to control my joints, so if I'm very weak in things like deadlifts, if I can't squat with a decent amount of weight, what will happen is that if I land from a jump, so if I'm a GA player and I jump to grab a ball and I land, that landing can create up to 2, 3, 4 times the amount of pressure or the amount of force that I weigh. So if I weigh 75 kg and I land, that could be like 150 or 225 kg worth of force going through my joints, okay? But if I don't have the strength to lift a decent amount of weight, say in a deadlift or a squat, what's going to happen when I land, my joints are going to be trying to take that 225 kg of force, and they're going to say, look, I'm not very strong, I can't handle that force, so it's going to start hurting, it's going to start painful, your tendons, your ligament, they're all going to start affecting you, okay? Whereas if I went away and I got strong, I started to do my shoulder presses, I started getting good at chin-ups, I started deadlifting, I got good at one-legged exercises like one-legged squats or lunges. What's going to happen then is I'm going to build up the muscles and the muscles around the joint. I'm going to build up the structural integrity of my joint. And then when I land, or I need to take off or I need to sprint, my joints are going to have the control, my joints are going to be steady enough, my muscles are going to control the stability of the joints and the tendons are going to control it. So when I drive off to get that to that ball or I land from a jump, now my joints say, okay, we can handle this, so it's going to be more efficient, okay, and less injuries. So what happens a lot of times is that, when people jump into these, they leave all this stuff out, okay, and it's really important because a lot of people get unnecessary injuries because something here is out. So they go in, they start squatting, yet they don't know, they can't touch their toes. Or they start to try to do shoulder presses, overhead pressing, to build up some upper body strength, yet they can't hold their hand in line with their ear. Okay? And what happens is that, for instance, if I can't get my hand in line with my ear, if I get restricted here, people go into the gym, they try and do their shoulder presses, and because they can't hold the weight out here, they start to lean back and they start to press up, okay? So what happens in that case is that if I'm leaning back and pressing up over my head with a dumbbell or a barbell, I'm going to be straining my back, okay? And eventually your back is going to start paining you. And what you're going to think is, going, geez, I've a problem with my back. I've a back pain, I've a back injury. But the original problem in this case was that I didn't have the shoulder mobility to press overhead. So I compensated, pushed my hips forward, my back got strained, I got pain, and then I related to having a back problem, okay? So in that case, to get better at the overhead pressing wouldn't involve pressing more, it would involve coming back to the basic movement skills and working on my joint mobility. Okay? So lad, when you're training, your strength and conditioning should be based on this or something like this. Get your lifestyle, get your sleep, your nutrition, eat your fruit and veg, take your recovery shakes, make sure you're hydrated. Your postural habits, you're not sitting for too long at work. Then you move up to the basic movement skills, your joint mobility, can you touch your toes? Can you pass the FMS test? Then you go to your general conditioning, then you go to your strength, your power, and your sport specific. Now that everyone is different, so depending on the person, some people have this nailed, they have this nailed, they need to start here. Other people, their nutrition is very bad, they're dehydrated, they're chronically dehydrated, they're really tight, they're really restricted in their joints, so they need to start at the bottom. Other people have everything here good, they can start to strengthen and work on. So it depends on the person, lads, but if you start doing this and implementing this into your strength and conditioning, you're going to be 99% ahead of the posse out there who are doing nothing like this, okay? So guys, you don't want to be getting unnecessarily injured or missing training time or missing your training events like your runs or your rugby matches or GA matches because your pyramid was out of sync, that there was something missing that affected something else up along the ladder that eventually caused you to get injured. So lads, I hope you got some good information out of this and start making use of it, and we'll talk to you again soon, okay?